Good morning, children. I hope you all are safe and sound by the grace of God. Okay, fine. Avoid going to crowded places, children, and always maintain physical distance. Okay, fine. I am Sarah Suhasini, and I am going to be your English teacher for this academic year, that is 2020-21. Okay, children. As I go through the lines of the text, I want you to underline the new words whichever you come across. And also concentrate on the pronunciation. Okay, how I am pronouncing the word. Try to learn that word. Okay, now today we'll see about a lesson where an elephant is injured in the forest and how it has been treated. Fine. The lesson name is Wet in the Forest. What is the lesson name, children? Wet in the Forest. And this lesson is written by Dhriti K. Lahiri Chowdhury. Dhriti K. Lahiri Chowdhury is an elephant expert. He has journeyed thousands of miles all over India in the quest of studying elephants. And he wrote a book, Trunk of Tales, that is his journey with the elephants, 70 long years with elephants. From that book, this is an extract. Wet in the Forest is an extract from Trunk of Tales, which was written by our author Dhriti K. Lahiri Chowdhury. And he published this book in both languages, that is in English as well as in Bengali. Fine, children? Now, we'll go to, as I read lines of the text, I want all of you to look into the lines of your textbook, page number 41. In April 1991, the East Medinipur Forest Division in West Bengal sought the help of Wildlife Wing of the Forest Department. So children, the writer is starting with the date as well as the place. So we can say it is a real incident happened. Okay, in April 1991, East Medinipur Forest Division, it is in West Bengal, children, it sought the help of. Now, we come across a new word, sought. What do you mean by sought? Sought is the past tense of seek. Past participle of seek. Means looking for. Okay, in search of. Okay, the forest division is looking for the help of the wildlife wing. Why it is looking for the wildlife wing? Why it is searching? Because in that forest, they are having certain problem. What is the problem? A young elephant, accompanied by a herd of more than 50 elephants, was injured and could not walk well. What happened, children? A young elephant accompanied. What do you mean by accompanied? Accompanied means going with someone to somewhere as a company. You are going with someone to a place as a company. Now here, an injured elephant is accompanied, means it is surrounded by or it is along with some other elephants. How many elephants it is mentioned, children? 50 more elephants are there with this injured elephant because it is unable to walk. All attempts to drive away the herd were unsuccessful, as the herd, after being driven away, always come back to rescue their injured teammate who was lagging behind. So all the attempts, who made these attempts? The villagers, the local tribal people, they made certain attempts. Attempts means trials, efforts to drive away this herd of elephants. Group of elephants is known as herd. H-E-R-D, herd. This herd of elephants, they are trying to drive away so that they can treat the injured elephant. But their attempts were failure. Because as they are driving away these elephants, they are again coming back to rescue. What do you mean by rescue, children, now? Rescue means saving a person who is in a danger or in a difficult situation. So the other elephants wants to save their teammate, wants to save their friend who is in difficulty. Okay, were unsuccessful and they are coming back to rescue their injured teammate who was lagging behind. Now, children, lagging behind. What do you mean by lagging behind? When someone is moving faster than you or others, you are falling behind. You are moving with a slower pace. So such a thing is known as lagging behind. Who is lagging behind now here? The injured elephant is lagging behind than the other elephants. So the other elephants are coming to save this elephant. Fine. Second paragraph, children. B arrived at the rest. Fine. Second paragraph, children. B arrived at the rest house of Bishnupur forest. Now, our narrator is using the word we. Now, in this word we, there are three people. Who are those three people? He clearly mentioned now. There were three of us. S-C-D-E. His name is S-C-D-E. He is the chief wildlife warden of the forest, that state forest. And Subrata Chaudhary. Subrata Chaudhary is the tranquilizing officer. Subrata Chaudhary is a tranquilizing officer and I a hanger-on. He is telling I a hanger-on. Now children, we will see one by one each person in specific. SCDE, the chief wildlife warden. Now warden, what do you mean by warden? We often say hostel warden like that, no? So what is warden? Warden means a person who takes the responsibility of supervising a place or an activity. Now here, this chief SCD is the chief wildlife warden of that West Bengal state. Now Subrata Chaudhary, he is the tranquilizing officer. We come across a new word now, tranquilizing. What do you mean by tranquilizing, children? Tranquilizer is giving a medicine to a sick animal or an injured animal to make it unconscious, so that treatment can be done. Tranquilizer is a medicine. Tranquilizer is given to a sick animal to make it unconscious. The person who gives tranquilizer is known as tranquilizing officer. Okay. Now, I a hanger-on is saying I. I is our narrator here now. A hanger-on. Hanger-on means a person who moves with a group of people without any specific duty or anything, just moving with a group. Okay, now along with this, our forest officer and tranquilizing officer, our narrator is also moving along with them to treat the injured elephant. Fine, children? Now, third paragraph. Look into third paragraph, all of you. It was getting uncomfortably hot, though it was only the middle of March. It was getting uncomfortably hot. When do you experience overheat, children? Especially during the months of April and mostly in the May. During that time, heat increases. But here, though it is only middle of March, they are experiencing uncomfortably heat, it seems. The herd and the injured elephant were constantly moving. Hence, the local forest staff could give us no exact information about its current location. Okay, so the herd and the injured elephant, the entire herd along with the injured elephant are constantly moving. What do you mean by constantly? Continuously. Always they are moving from one place to other place. They are not in a particular place. So the local forest staff, whoever has been, who complained this particular incident to the officers, this staff is unable to give exact information where the current location of the injured elephant is. A current location means exact location. Fourth paragraph. We had just decided to inquire among the villagers when a young man belonging to one of the local tribes approached us and said he knew where the injured elephant was. Now, we had just decided to inquire. What do you mean by inquire, children? Now, I wanted to give you a specific detail about this inquire. Please note down this, children. Inquire. We had just decided to inquire the local villagers. Now, our narrator is using the word inquire. What do you mean by inquire or inquire? What is the difference between inquire and enquire? Do you know, children? Inquire and enquire are both one and the same. Inquire is also gathering the information, getting information. Enquire is also getting information. But inquire is done by specific department people. That is police department, CID department. Now here forest department people are inquiring the villagers. That is the local tribal people. Enquire is normal way of gathering information, getting information. Teacher may ask, your neighbor may ask, your mother enquired. Okay, this enquire is denoted for general way of getting information. Okay, inquire for specific thing, specific department people. Okay, children, make a note of this. They inquired among the villagers when a young man. Now, these three team are inquiring about the information, a young man came to the team and said, "Sir, I know where the injured elephant is." Okay, children? Now, what information that the local tribal young man has given to this team, and how the team detected or trapped the elephant, and how they started the treatment, we will see in the next class, children. Fine? Okay, children. And now, as I have explained many new words, children, you read the text thoroughly once again and try to learn these new words along with the meanings which I have written on the board. Okay, children? Thank you. Stay safe and stay healthy. Bye.